And welcome back to my channel Physio Trends. And today's video, as you can see, I'm going to demonstrate you and tell you some facts about the ultrasound, how you should use it, how you should not use it, and everything. A very important point before giving any hitting modality is checking the sensations of the patient. So that is must you should remember that whenever you want to give any superficial hitting modalities, first you should check for the sensations of the patient and then only start with the treatment. The next thing is what medium we are using for giving the ultrasound. So normally we use this ultrasonic gel for giving the ultrasound, which provides a good medium for transforming the waves to the skin. Sometimes if patient gets hurt or patient has severe pain that they are not allowing you to go for direct contact of the ultrasonic head, then we can also use water immersion technique. In water immersion technique, again patient's limb or part of the area which is affected will be immersed in the water, and some distance far away ultrasonic wave is used for transforming the waves. But as the rule of attenuation, there will be more refraction and reflection because the distance is more, but still some of the absorption will be there for the ultrasonic waves. So let's begin with first understanding what is ultrasound and how does it work. So basically, as you can see, this equipment, it has got one ultrasonic head. On this head we can see one metal fixed over it, and inside that there is a crystal. Okay, that crystal is exact size of this head, and that is why we learn in the theory also that amount of area which we can treat with the ultrasound head always determined with the head of the ultrasound. For example, I'll tell that if the head of the ultrasound is of 2 centimeters of square, then with this head I can treat only 4 centimeters square of the area of the particular patient. But so obviously, like if the area is decreased, then area of treatment also is going to decrease, and if the area of ultrasonic head increases, the area of treatment also increases.
So make sure that when you are using ultrasound, you are using it according to the head of the device and treatment area. So we should never do this kind of treatment for the area of the treatment. Always we have to consider the ultrasound head size and the area of treatment.
Now the next point is, what is piezoelectric effect? Piezoelectric effect is nothing but movement of the crystal inside the ultrasonic head, which creates the sound wave and which are transmitted inside the body. Next question comes that why do we have 1 megahertz as well as 3 megahertz in the ultrasound? So for that we need to understand the attenuation. Now what is attenuation? So attenuation is nothing but reflection, refraction, and absorption. This we have studied in the physics also, but some things we have forgotten. So I'm going to just give you some details about it. Like whenever we are penetrating something over the skin, half of the things are directly reflected back. So let me say, like if I am giving ultrasound with the intensity of 1, okay, so half of it is going reflected because of the ultrasonic head when you are moving on the treatment area, and half of the thing penetrates, out of which half is refracted and half is going to get absorbed. So that is why 1 megahertz and 3 megahertz have their own importance. Now let's understand what happens in 1 megahertz and which all areas and which all treatment it can be used. So we know that 1 megahertz is mostly used whenever you want to go for deep penetration. Because as I told you, more the attenuation, more there will be reflection. So that is why 1 megahertz, then it will be reflected also that much less and absorption will be that much. And 3 megahertz, then reflection will be more, even more than 1 megahertz. So that is why 1 megahertz always used for deep penetration. How much deep it can penetrate? The next question is there. So it can penetrate up to 5 centimeters. Okay. Now in this, something also called as continuous ultrasound and pulsed ultrasound. Now what is the difference? Continuous, in simple term we can say yes, continuous means that the waveform are continuously given, and pulsed means there is a duty cycle. Like if we say normally according to research, 20% of duty cycle is taken for giving the pulsed ultrasound, in which 20% of the time the ultrasonic wave will be given and rest 80% it will not be given. Let me tell you one example, that if it is a time period of 10 seconds and you are giving ultrasound with 20% duty cycle, that means 2 seconds we are giving the ultrasonic waves and 8 seconds there is a rest period. So how to calculate this duty cycle? So for that there is a simple formula that on time divided by on time plus off time. Moving forward to 3 megahertz. 3 megahertz normally given for the superficial heating and the superficial area treatment. Whenever you have to penetrate the ultrasonic waves at least up till 1 or 2 centimeters. And for that intensity also has to be kept low because as I told you it is a heating modalities, it can produce a heat inside the tissues. So that is why for 3 megahertz intensity is kept low around 0.5, 0.75, and depends on the whether you are using pulse or you are using continuous. Next thing we have to understand about the ultrasound is phonophoresis. Now what is phonophoresis? We know that we normally use drugs or let's say ointment along with the ultrasonic waves so that we can penetrate the medicines deeply. But do they really penetrate deeply? My answer will be no. According to researches, it says that it penetrates only till the superficial area. So it's again a doubt whether we should use with the phonophoresis or we should not. But again, certain conditions, it has been given a very good reports. So that is why we can use it. And some conditions, even if you are using without phonophoresis, you can use it. The next point is which are medications we can use in the phonophoresis. So mostly we can use dexamethasone, okay, that is the anti-inflammatory, or we can use Licodin, which is an analgesic, okay. So these two can be used for anti-inflammatory as well as for the pain relieving.